So we've completed the most comprehensive neuropsychological study of professional ice hockey players to date. This study was started in 2010, and these are the first set of results now being published in the Journal of Neurology, Neurosurgery, and Psychiatry. We found that in comparison to a control group, the retired professional ice hockey players were free of significant impairment on tests of mental and cognitive function. However, subjective reports in the alumni indicated a high level of behavioral, cognitive, and emotional problems in comparison to the control group. We focused on retired professional ice hockey players' cognitive and mental function in relation to age, concussion history, and genetic risk. The professional athletes were compared to an age-matched group of control subjects with no history of participation in high-level contact sports and no history of significant concussions. All the participants completed a lengthy battery of neuropsychological paper and pencil tasks, as well as computerized tasks and brain imaging studies. They also completed a series of questionnaires relating to their own experience of cognitive, behavioral, and emotional functioning. We also collected blood samples from all participants to look at genetic markers related to cognitive function and dementia. We observed that the alumni and comparison participants performed to a similar level on measures of attention and memory. However, the alumni did have a subtle disadvantage on tests of executive function. Executive function tests measure higher level cognitive processes involved in thinking, decision making, and control of other mental processes. So this study is really just a snapshot in time looking at the comparison of two groups. However, the best way to conduct this research is longitudinally, which means testing people over time to look at how their function might change with age. We're continuing to recruit participants both for the first phase, the initial testing, as well as the longitudinal follow-up test. And we're currently preparing papers related to the brain imaging findings from these participants.